usually the system was that the top four sides, usually were the sides that were asked to participate in games overseas, and Hawthorn enjoying the success they did during the 80s, we were one of the first sides usually selected, and that's how we got there. Well, you've got to understand they wouldn't have had the success unless they were a very professional side.
Jason Dunstall, George Stone, we've finally arrived in Miami. How many cans do you have, Jason?
Well, we managed to get through in the low 30s.
Low 30s?
Low 32. George lagged a bit on 30.
George, could you keep up with him? How did you find it?
Well, I'm pretty happy with my 30. I thought I worked very hard in the midsection of the game, and I'd hope the selection committee would look after me when the votes come out.
Well, the target was 45. There's an hour bus trip to come. What have you got planned?
Yeah, I think one of the things that put us behind target was the service on the plane. Twice on two legs they ran out.
Well, let's hope you can get a slab going on the bus and get that record of 45.
We've got to have two slabs at least.
We're certainly looking at the 45. That's not beyond us, but we may have to get him to do a couple of laps of honour before the...
Well,
I was very pleased that in the professional manner they went about it. And they're very mature.
Platts laid the worst ever heard. It just went on and on and on. Everybody's gone into tears.
One of the great assets of the Hawthorn Football Club is the way they usually handle themselves. And just because we were overseas, we continued in the same vein. And I was very pleased in the manner they went about it.
Excuse me. Do you know what birdies sell? Now, would you look at the camera? So am I. I'm a foreigner. And I want to be part of it.
I used to always say, one of the reasons to win a game is the ability to be able to adapt to the conditions of the day, and they took it further and they were able to adapt to the customs of that particular country. I think these exercises are great for the game. No comment.
Japan Airlines, flight 722 to Japan with the Hawthorn Football Club. And we've just caught up with young Gary Bacanaro. Gary, how are you?
Not too bad, thanks, Robert.
You've just been stacking some Zeds there, have you, Gary?
Yes, I've been putting a few away. Very nice Zeds too.
Any particular dreams you've had so far?
Not as yet. Not enough time, my dreams, for that sort of dream, Robert.
Right, Gary, look. There's been a lot of controversy over that last goal you've kicked in the preliminary final. Obviously, if you don't want to talk about it, that's quite fine. Any comments that you'd like to make, you know, offhand?
What would you like to ask, Robert?
Well, I'd like to ask exactly, was it a fairly stupid act on the part of young Steins to run through your mark? Thanks, Gary. Obviously, I want to commit yourself there. Are you looking forward to a good trip? Thanks, Gary. And anything else you'd like to add?
Not really.
You all right? Right, we're just about to interview the young lady now. Excuse me, miss. Excuse me. Would you give an interview for a moment? How are you today? She seems a bit shy to talk to us. Konnichiwa.
I cannot speak English.
Ah, I see. Yes, it is a lovely day. Well, look, thanks very much for that interview. We'll catch you a little later, all right? Bye-bye.
Good afternoon, everybody. We're a couple of Australians. We're about to sing Advance Australia Fair. Ready? From the top. We all know where Australia is, do we? All right.
Australia's sunset.
Species of Japanese people you find on trains is the religious type. Just follow me, thanks.
Just come on down here. We'll find that we caught them during their prayers, and we'll get a quick interview if we could. Sir, is it true that Pee Wee Platten and yourself have something in common? Right. Perhaps an easier question to the lady on the right. We Westerners find that Most of you Japanese people look remotely similar. Is this the reason why you have that boogie hanging out of your nostril?
The last and final contender. Quite a stern man across here.
Now descending the stairs is the Japanese mafia. Frightening.
Will you marry me? Will you marry me?
False advertising. How are you?
How are you?
How's life? Oh. That hat you've got there, is that, I'll show you a little trick here. Watch this. Ready?
Yeah.
Just as hard as getting a word out of the Japanese people. Ooh.
Don't you just hate people making a spectacle of themselves?
The rigged deer has found some friends.
One of the many shops in the market in Japan. And you're all crooks, aren't you? That's right, because they're selling swatch watch for well over $50, and well, that makes them crooks.
Yeah. They were able to adapt to the customs of that particular country.
Absolutely wonderful night. How big is Gary Bacanara? Look over here, Gary Bacanara. Hello, Gary, I just wonder if you could just tell our viewers how things went last night.
Bucky's big in Perth.
Now we know that. Now I understand that you I understand that you want to get a taxi license. Is this true? Could you tell everyone how you hail taxis?
Jump on the bonnet.
You jump on the bonnet. That's it. This is the only way you can stop Japanese taxis here. The bear. Now the bear. Now the bear, he met an American bloke, his name was again?
Mr. Wall Street.
His first name is Dow.
Dow, and he was an exciting man to meet last night, this is true.
He was over here looking for a pianist.
Apparently we found one. Apparently we have one in Australia.
We found the world's best pianist last night.
And who that may be?
Very subtle fingers, a man from Perth it was.
Mr. Gary Bacanara, he is an extraordinary person.
Good morning, here we are. Thanks Rob Dickson for this opportunity to say hello to everyone back home in Melbourne. We are Yokohama and we have all the boys here. What are you doing? Get back on me. We're ready to train. We've had a big night, had a couple of hours sleep. Here we have the groundsman, Gary Hukanara. Excuse me, Gary. How many us all?
The boys have just finished training. Let's have a few words to the young guys. Now, Jerry, how did you feel after that sensational night, the way you trained?
I felt fine today, sonny.
Absolutely. Lolly, what about you, son? Did you have a good day?
Sensational.
Sensational. Now, this man here got his ass wiped.
No comment.
Now, did you have an early night last night?
Yeah, fairly.
Early night. Okay, that's all from 60 Minutes.
There's a rumour going around that a certain player in the Hawthorn Football Club waxes his bum. Who is this bum?
Not altogether happy with that at all.
We have Robert Dickson, and we thank him very much for giving us a free moment of his. Hi, Robert. Here we are at Yokohama, and how does it feel?
I need a specific question, thanks, Chris.
You need a specific question?
Specific.
And here we have Dermot Brereton. Just thanks, Dermot. And what would you like to ask me, Robert?
Chris, exactly how's the game going so far?
Very well. We're waiting here for the Japanese Hawthorn team to come out and play against us here, so we're just waiting and then we'll get back to you then.
Oh! 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 Oh
Keep going, Frank.
Run at it. Oh, my God.
Excuse me, Andy Collins? Andy, just before you take off, let's explain to the people here in Japan what sort of day or time you've had here in the last 7 days.
Well, actually, I've quite enjoyed myself. I've found it...
First time here?
Yes,
excellent.
First time, and found it an extremely fascinating place. People are extremely friendly, and it's a good time.
Would you come back with perhaps family sometime?
No.
I think, look, there's Gary Bucanara. Here he is, Gary Bucanara. Gary, before you go, would you just please explain to the people in Japan what sort of time you've had here?
Yes!
Well, all we've got to say is...
No comment.
Johnny Patton! Oh, look, it's a wonder to meet you, son. Could you just please explain to the people in Japan what sort of time you've had here?
Yeah, good time. We've seen a few little places and we had a couple of drinks and we were very quiet, but we'll be maybe back here next year.
Oh, Dermot, please don't go without saying a word. Dermot, to all your fans here in Japan, we'd like to say... What would you like to say though?
Oh, big daddy baby, 10-4 and rifle tit and dollar five.
Wow, did you get that, people? And I understand you bought one of the best checkers you ever bought in your life. This is Daisy Williams.
Daisy, what a legend in his own lifetime. He's a fine man. I don't think I've ever met a man of his stature who can drink as much as he can.
Okay, are you looking forward to going home?
No, I adore this place. I wish I could live here.
Would you come back here with family one day?
Well, I do intend settling down here someday. It is
look,
a splendid place. I'll leave it over to you, Robert, and we're off, Robert. Come on, let's go.
Look, one of our interpreters, Zorro, would you please explain to the people back in Australia what sort of time you've had with the Australian players here at the Hawthorn Football Club? And they'd be serious about it.
Be serious about it? They're nice people. They're bad, but they're... Oh, they're bad.
They're bad?
Caught up with young Gary Bucanara almost a year to the day that I first interviewed him on the way to Japan. Gary, how are you?
Oh, I'm very well after a couple of hours kip and watching a nice movie and having a couple of quiet beers.
John Kennedy reporting from Harrods in London. I've got Russell Morris here with me today. Russell would like to say a few words.
I'm very mixed up, Robert. I don't know where we are.
John, I'm Robert, he's John.
Robert's holding the camera.
Jacko.
He's like feeding him.
Right, now, Russell wants me to be serious because we're in Harrods and you can't, and you really, Fire said you cannot fart in Harrods. This is now, we're getting a close-up shot of Frankie selecting a few trendy clothes.
You get this badge, what is it, Gamers? You can't go wrong.
Trent Duval.
Magnificent.
Oh, wow. Right, thanks, John. We'll just follow me for a second. We're just sneaking up on a few Harrods people. A few little shopkeepers. Excuse me. We're Australian visitors to Harrods, and we're from 60 Minutes in Melbourne. We'd like a few little comments on how you think Harrods and how do you think about Biafrans.
I'm sorry, what did you say?
A sensible question.
What do you think of Harrods?
Yeah, what do you think of Harrods exactly?
personally.
And what do you think about magnets?
Magnets?
You're on Australia Television.
Aren't you?
I'm not joking.
Oh my God.
It's live too, what's more.
See Ashley and weigh in.
That was the ugliest girl I've ever, ever seen in my life.
Piccadilly Square, tell me about it.
Absolutely magnificent, Jack. Unbelievable. Absolutely. It's almost give you
a... Yeah, right. Now, what about Gomez, the father figure of the little unit we got here going today? Gomez, you're a champion. You're a champion.
It's just part of being a booster on these trips.
Up with Barbara Streisand, my gosh, and we'd like a profile shot of Barbara. Barbara, memories, cats.
Oh, I see.
What are you doing here?
Well, I'm trying to sell this. All you have to
do. Could you sing to me while you're answering?
I can't sing. But look, all you have to do is put your name there and your address there, and you could win £100.
Did you really have a bit of a fling with Ryan O'Neill?
No, I didn't.
Didn't you?
No.
Well, thanks, Lily.
It's Johnson.
Sorry?
It's Johnson.
Ben Johnson?
No, what's his name, Johnson?
Thank you very much.
Here we are, ruin it. Here we are in Carnaby Street, and I'm going to introduce Michelle. She's going to toast us today, okay?
Okay. I feel stupid, but here's a toast to all you guys who have just hopped off the plane, and it looks like you're settling down well to pints.
Gomez talking about then Rue spotted this girl in red on the tube and said that her what's her favourite?
I don't know what you're talking about.
What's your favourite?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Well, Rue said whatever it is, that it was as big as Big Ben. It was as big as Big Ben.
So we're here.
We're here with Big Ben, and we're going to take a steroid test on Dickie.
I thought it quite appropriate in front of Big Ben.
Why, John?
I'm freezing. And Rue, is it good for footy?
Football's not the big winner, Ed.
Standing outside the biggest construction ever in Dickie's life.
Dear Forum, I'm a 27-year-old university student, and I thought I had to write to you and share an experience that happened to me with my fellow readers. Whilst walking in the streets with my partner, Richard Loveridge, we were reading a map. I hailed a cab quickly, and Dickie and I rushed to get our newfound love into our cab. Whilst rushing towards the cab, John Kennedy appeared from nowhere. The rest I'll leave to your imagination.
Okay, this is the day. Here we are at the Oval. Robert, would you just mind scanning over? The players are very excited about being here. The weather hasn't been too kind to us, but at least there's no wind. Let's go talk to one of the champions of our side. We've got Jason Dunstall. Good morning, Jason.
How are you, Bertie?
All right, now, do you feel very excited about being here?
Oh, terrific, mate.
I mean, you're playing the MCG.
How would you compare this to the MCG?
It's like a lawn bowling green, isn't it?
Yeah, my word. And are you looking forward to leading to the Dipper?
Yeah, mate, I love the wet. The conditions suit me. And I reckon if you get a kick, I'll get a kick.
Okay, fair enough. Thank you very much for that interview there, Jason.
Dickie, how do you feel about the captaincy today?
Very pleased about the captaincy here today, Dicko.
Before the big game, go back and I remember me from Japan. We interviewed before the big game in Japan. Here we are in London. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling good. I'm feeling real good. I've been psyched up for this one. It's been a long time since Japan, and I think air of excitement in the rooms here in London today.
I mean, you play a bit of cricket too, and here you are playing cricket on the oval. Do you feel anything towards that?
Yeah, I think I might go out with me pads on today.
Pads, yes. Footy's the big winner.
Good afternoon and welcome here to the Oval, Foster's Oval. Very tight game here. A lot of things here that are good for football. Dixie Marshall being one of them. And as we look around the ground, the weather has been resurrected. It was a shocker in the morning. And the ground is really well, it's a lake. It's a green lake, but it's a lake. And players who have played well, Tony Hall, as usual, the magician. Gary Buchanan picking up kicks. Andy Growler, more marks on him than just playing very well anyway.
One of the present world champs of the Hawthorn football team, Eddie Rabbit. Would I say a few words about your performance today, Ed?
Nah.
A few more than that, Ed?
Nah.
Was it good for footy, Ed?
Yeah.
The big Bear. How did he come off today, Bear, with the injuries?
Oh, very serious injuries. A couple of bad ones today. Bunghole. The ball actually hit him on the foot at one stage. And he's got the bad foot.
What about my back, Baz?
Is there any truth in the rumour that Jason Dunster will be the world's worst player today in the World Cup?
The Wog Award, isn't it? Worst on the ground.
I'd agree with that. Anything else you can report to us, Baz?
Eddie's got the knives in the back. Big knife right in the middle of his back.
Pass, do you see any on the boundary line today?
A bit of dare. I keep my eye open on one side of the ground, the other side of the ground, and I've told a couple of blokes during the game, so boys just put in very well.
Okay, here he is, world champion, captain for the day. A sensational performance, Richard Loveridge. Would you like to say a few words?
Oh, as we said before the game, Dicko predicted the win, and we've come good with the goods. Great win at the Oval. First for Hawthorn. Terrific stuff.
Would you like to give a few comments on Johnny Platton's fart at the beginning of the game?
John Platton's fart me up because trying to be captain, trying to be serious, John Kennedy f***ing around, Dermot always laughing. Platt's laid the worst fart ever heard that just went on and on and on. Everybody's gone into tears.
Is there truth in the rumour that they blew a hole in his jocks?
Absolutely, yes, and I think it hit someone. Went through his jocks and hit someone.
The World Cup runner, George Stone. Say a few words, George.
Well, Roo, I suppose it's been a big day for everyone.
Yes.
And Platt's, now I'd just like to say that I've run in Tokyo, now I've run in London, run in the MCG. Where else do I have to run?
One of the biggest flogs of all time. Terry, the goal umpire for today. Terry, say a few words about your performance today. How was it?
Very ordinary, Harry.
Add anything to that?
No.
Here comes Junior, the most beautiful girl of all time. She's on camera. Quietly. What do you think about love?
Well, it's a four-letter word, and I suppose a lot of four-lettering goes on when it's conducted.
What do you think about love? Do you think it's good for footy?
Yes.
Movies are great, aren't they? I hope you're enjoying the one down here tonight. Just let me tell you something. Movies cost a lot of money. That's where I come in. I'm your sponsor tonight. I'm Hank Riboldi. People call me Hanky. I love Mickle, Bob. I've loved it for years and I've drunk it for years. And I wrote myself a little poem that goes like this. You can offer me a Faustus, but it won't pass my lips. You can give me a Heineken, but it gives me the shits. Some say Lowenbrow's a nice little brew, but I had me one once and it made me spew. I've heard people say, Cronenberg, how about a moose? I've had them too, and they made my bowels loose. Someone walked up and slapped a Corona on the table. But for Hanky, my friends, there's one beer, one label. So when you're tired and thirsty, after a day on the job, I reach for my favorite, my old Mickle.
Man, only as Jason Dunstall on the Sun classified ad in all around Melbourne. He's now in London. He's huge. Spot over here on the edge of the water. Little spot, that's Dickie Loveridge with all his mates over there. Geez, he's a popular bloke, isn't he?
We've just caught a bar Ranium. Here we have, they're lending their Japanese.
We're now moving on from Tower Hill to Victoria Station. We're going to the Buckingham Palace bit.
Here looks a couple of likely looking businessmen. Excuse me, sir. How are you?
We're from Australia, 60 Minutes. We've got a live interview.
Yeah.
We're just wondering if you could tell us the finer aspects of England.
The finer aspects of England? Well, as far as I'm concerned, this is a fine day. It may not be for an Australian because it's not warm enough for you.
Right.
Would that be right?
Have you heard of John Kennedy?
Have I heard of John Kennedy?
He's a Hawthorn footballer.
No.
He's good for football, and you're good for football. Thanks very much.
Sure, he is a good footballer.
Thanks,
okay.
All the best.
Nice.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star. Okay? Ready, set, go.
Twinkle, twinkle, little star.
JFK. I might give him a bit of an interview here. John, how are you going?
Yeah, thanks, Greg.
That's good. We're just questioning at the moment on your ability to have a bit of movement in the forward line. We've had a rumour, heard a rumour that this is actually you, this chap over here in the red. This is what you do in the forward line when you're sitting in the forward pocket. Is there any truth in that rumour?
Shit, I'm not as quick as him, mate.
Chris Langford, the master of sartorial eloquence, has got the worst socks on in the world. Puma socks with nice brown brogues, blue jeans, and the absolute shockers.
Hey, ladies and gentlemen, welcome to Bertie's Shoe Shop. I've been a part of this establishment now for about 30 years. Follow me. Oh, it's a very beautiful shop here. You must be very quiet.
Someone's on the telephone. Over there, get the shot on the telephone.
Hello everybody and welcome to St Paul's Cathedral, London, where we're doing a bit of sightseeing around here. And it's nice to see you Aussies getting some culture and some refinement at long last. And Rob has the cutest bum ever, and I think it's good for football.
But you probably don't recognise who this is. Yes, it is me. This is a coup. Here we are at the cockpit of flight 857, I think it is. And with the captain here, Ed. How are you, Ed?
I'm well. How are you?
Very good, thank you. Clint?
Oh, just great.
That's terrific. And
how are you?
All right. At the moment, I think we're over Greenland, so I can see some green land out there. But we'll just ask the other boys, where are we? Ed, could you please tell us where we are?
Yes, we're in the air.
We're in the air. Have you got any idea what's underneath us?
No.
Have you got any idea where we're going?
It doesn't really matter.
Okay. What does another wing out of the clouds mean? Does that mean there's a plane coming towards us?
Hey, Ted, John. It's okay. There's one thing better than Niagara Falls.
Well, here we are, Niagara Falls, and quite frankly, I'm quite disappointed. I can't see what all the big deal's about. Unbelievable.
Craig, what do you think about Niagara Falls?
Well, to tell you the truth, Dipper, I can't believe we've driven 2 hours just to see this.
He's very disappointed.
Well, you know, Dyke's Falls at the back of Collingwood's just as good as this, I reckon.
Yeah, so actually when I was younger, I used to go rowing at the back of Collingwood, but ended up playing for Hawthorn. Anyway, that's another story. So from here, where do you expect to go?
Well, I'm very disillusioned by this whole day, actually, Dipper, but, you know, 2 hours to see this, just a lot of water falling off a cliff.
Well, keeps you at the hotel for 2 hours, anyway.
That's true.
Okay, now we'll get Peter Lander to sign off.
Is this for SBS or for Channel 7?
Just use your hands, will you?
Get on your birdie.
Well, fortunately, we've caught up with Lou Richards, and I just want to ask him one particular question, Lou. Is your wardrobe full of Channel 9 jumpers?
Yes, they are. As a matter of fact, they were full of Channel 7 jumpers for years, but I've sold those, and now I've made a profit with the Channel 9 ones.
There's a rumour going around that you just tipped out, Gibbo just tipped you out for the $10 million contract to go to Channel 10. Is that true for the Olympics? Or?
Well, actually, I didn't declare my salary. It's more than Gibbo's because I'm a bigger superstar than Gibbo.
What do you think of Niagara, Lou? Is it beautiful?
Well, I'd rather have the Augusta Stores any day than the Niagara Falls, wouldn't you?
Is it good for football?
I think it's great for football. I think the more of Niagara Falls we have, football will certainly go ahead.
It'll be the big winner, you reckon?
It'll be the big winner, and of course, there's one thing that amazes me. There's so much water here.
Thanks, Lou. Appreciate that. Well, what do you think of love, Lou?
I love love. But at my age now, I've taken starts, plaster of Paris, and even used splints, but it doesn't seem to help me very much.
With the VFL Chairman Commissioner, Mr. Ross Oakley. Ross, what do you think about Niagara Falls?
Look, football is the winner.
Niagara Falls, we're just passing the Canadian Falls. As you can see, representatives from all four teams are here.
Who was the big winner here?
I should take a point.
Well, due to the lack of absence of Gary Buchanan, we've breaking precedence with the interviews. But we've got our captain for the tour, Peter Schwab. Pete, how are you?
Oh, a little bit lost, Robert, really.
A little bit lost. You've had a long and arduous flight so far. Can you remember Hawaii at this stage?
No, I've lost about 6 hours out of my life.
Well, I remember it, Peter, and it was quite embarrassing. There you were in the transit lounge looking quite pale, looking quite sick. Had a bit of a vomit. A real captain's effort, yes. Got anything to add to that?
No, I really can't remember what happened. All I remember is landing here at Los Angeles.
Captain for the tour, you've got some big boots to fill. Gary Ayres, Ricky Loveridge was a captain once. How do you feel about that?
Well, I didn't bring my wife, so I think I'm ahead of one of the blokes who was captain.
Excuse me, you guys from, where are you guys from?
We've got Simon Madden here just interjecting as usual.
No,
Simon?
I love your accent. Where are you from?
Simon, how are you feeling after long and arduous flight?
I'm sorry, I can't understand you. Where's that accent from? You're from England?
No, not from England, no.
Oh, I've got a relation in England, I'm sorry.
And here we are, coming up to Jewel Rabi Stadium with the boys.
And Yab's having a bit of a laugh at us during this interview, and we're all a bit tense before the game, and I'd like to ask a couple of questions to a couple of young players. Firstly, Mr. Rob Dickson, who unfortunately is here to redeem himself and hopefully have a big game, Rob.
Redeem myself, Chris?
We won't go into that. Anyway, Dean.
Oh, thank you.
And are you going, Andrew? Going? And we have another young superstar with lovely hair, Dean Anderson. How do you feel tonight?
I'm pretty confident. Witty?
We have Darren and Jinx laughing in the background there. Come forward, please, Darren. For special comments. Okay, we have... can you get both his heads in, please, Andrew?
Dermot, I understand that you found new family on the West Coast earlier this week.
Yes, a few of my relatives did move out to America. You know, some go to Australia.
And you had a great day over there.
Yes, wonderful, wonderful 2 days there, Richard.
Terrific.
I'm just going to do the pitch test with a key. Got the key for the hotel. And we're going to see what the humidity's like as we go down now. Boys, come down.
Come down with us, everyone down at this.
The key, as you can see, fits into the dirt.
In
so
the
there's a little bit of moisture here. I think it's
how
a good,
hot is it, growler?
It's a good wicket.
Well, Robert, remember at the Oval 12 months ago, the weather was very similar to as it is today. Deep thought, Darren?
Time, what's time?
We've only got a few seconds. All right.
Boys,
no, actually, just hold that. Hold it.
No, doing the shake.
Stop the film! What's going on here? I'm totally disgusted at the excess use of nudity. What are you trying to achieve here?
All the boys are just wondering, how big is your schlong?
How big is my what?
How big is your schlong? You know, your hooter.
What is that?
Your big munja I hang in between.
On the beach at Bahamas, the boys have found the shade here, Laurie. Do you play here each day, boys?
3 days a week.
3 days a week?
Yep.
What do you do on the other four?
We'll look for lolly.
Look for lolly. What is lolly?
It's a talk in Bahamas.
The talk in Bahamas? Yeah. You look for talk in Bahamas?
Lolly.
Lolly?
Yeah.
What's talk for what?
That's just a talk.
Are we talking girls?
Yeah.
Yeah. All right.
And Andy Demetriou, how are you feeling your last game, Andy?
I think it's a relief more than anything, Robert.
You were quite emotional after the game?
Oh, well, it's the last game and I know I don't have to train anymore, so I think I was happy with joy more than anything.
Peter Schwab down here is the captain for tonight's effort and he's got a huge cut on his eye. How do you feel, Pete, at the moment?
Retired, Robert, very tired.
Who is this bum?
Another bloody nude shot. I'm sick of it. It's not funny. It's a bloody disgrace.
There's some sort of a creep falling all over me here.
Is it the best kiss you ever had in your life?
Well, it's one of the best kisses.
She called me a foreigner. Do I look like a foreigner? Watch them turning around. I want to sail across the ocean. I've grown weary of this town. Take the pressure down. Cause I can. What's this over excess use of nudity?
Take all of the wheels. You're a bit lost for words, damn it.
Who's going to be doing this, Richie?
You're giving it away, Dermot. It was meant to be quite subtle.
A lot of frustration shown by the boys. As you can hear, Mad Dog's going crazy. Hutto, what do you reckon?
Turn the engine off!
I just want to know whose idea this was to come on this trip.
I like playing football, yeah.
You have a nickname then?
I have a nickname. My nickname is Rat. Why laugh?
Why?
Why? Because I get in the places which I shouldn't.